Security has been tightened in Oyam ahead of the by-election. Electoral equipment was also handed over by Oyam Electoral Commission returning officer Richard Onoba, who presented it to the security forces and agents of the candidates. However, one of the box seals was broken, but on inspection, it was discovered that everything was still intact. According to Onoba, the voting materials will be safely delivered to the polling stations and all is set for the election. According to Onoba, the equipment delivered includes 167 black ballot boxes, 167 transparent ballot boxes, registers, biometric voter verification kits, among others. He also confirmed the delivery of welfare for the polling officials across the 167 polling stations. He also confirmed the delivery of welfare for the polling officials across the 167 polling stations.
Buli polling station ina ballot box yayo zetufunye kati we are sorting them tulimuzi kuzi sortinga according to sub counties in the polling stations toka tuzitedeke encha college encha tuzitwa to distributing ku polling stations.
Security has been tightened and no complaints have been received so far, according to the North Joga Police spokesperson, Patrick Jimmy Okema.
On day one, that is beginning with NRM primaries, nominations of the candidates, campaign periods of the 10 days, I want to sincerely say it was well managed and secured. We extend our appreciation to members of the public, the various leadership from all the political parties who brought in their candidates.
The Electoral Commission Chairperson, Justice Simon Biabakama, met with the candidates' agents and law enforcement officers and briefed them on the election process. He promised a truthful and fair election.
Stakeholders joining hands with us and shall deliver the election.
North Joga RPC Obura Deo reiterated the commitment by security to ensure a peaceful election, warning voters against any form of violence.
We all know our individual roles. Let's stick to them. We know the rules and regulations that govern elections. Do your part, shall do ours. Let's help those who don't know do the right thing. And on the 6th, which is tomorrow, the exercise goes on well, and we shall all celebrate.
The meeting, however, got heated up at some point, as agents expressed security concerns, saying they have been threatened. These raised their voices, and this forced the Electoral Commission chairperson to first halt the meeting. But it later gained momentum, and it commenced. The agents raised a number of concerns that should be addressed ahead of the voting day tomorrow.
I think the street is intimidating. Yes. Sit and listen to this rubbish. What does the law say about official people coming past the elections over here? What does the law say?
Excuse me.
I'm a student of the law,
excuse
Mr. Chairman.
It's
the day we are witnessing and seeing our electoral materials being put here. We have actually checked each and every box. They are all intact. There are no complaints. There was only one complaint whereby one of the seals broke, but we verified it actually, and they are all fine. There is no any complaint about this, and personally, I agree on that.
Sub-counties around Oyam North and find out where the problems are in each sub-county. It will not be I, it will be we. That is the agenda of UPC. We go by people, people's mandates. That is what we are going to do after the election, when we succeed.
Four candidates are contesting to replace slain minister and retired Charles Okello Engola. These include Dr. Eunice Apio Otuko of the UPC, Samuel Junior Engola from the NRM, Freddie Newton Okello of FDC, and Daniel Okello of the National Unity Platform. Oyam North County voters will head to the polls tomorrow to decide their next member of parliament. Report compiled by Abdul Muwonge for the news.